Well, we're joining this match at the Emirates Arena, and it's Linda Sakini from Bulgaria. Very good left-handed player, been on the circuit a long, long while. Very talented player, lots of shots, playing against the Russian, not sure of her name.
POLIKARPOVA, right?
POLIKARPOVA, Kesnia POLIKARPOVA, which will be the first time I've seen this girl. Heavily braced left knee, which is never a good sign. Both players have their knees taped. Lots of players that play in these championships, and it's because it's Olympic qualification year, it's a really heavy year for a lot of players. They pick up niggly injuries and they have to keep on going because the points are so important to them. Often to the point that they will just walk onto the court if they're injured to gain the points.
So Ray, at this level, what are you expecting tonight in this match?
Well, I've never really seen the Russian girl so early on, but even just from the knock-up, I know Zucchini's level, but I don't know the Russian girl's level, but she's a good player, Linda.
I think the Russian girl started quite strong. She looks quite a strong and physical player, and coming from Russia, you know that she's likely to work very, very hard for it.
She certainly looks strong, Craig, but I'm going to wait for her mobility to get tested, really. Certainly a good start. And that's the first time the Russian girl's been moved to full distance. Like so much of badminton now, they're only really pulled in from the front line when it's net play. So I think that if Linda really wants to perform well in this match, she's got to make her move real full distances.
Yeah. I think that the other thing I noticed from there, that's twice she's got a bit of success down there. The forehand of the Bulgarian player on the smash.
Certainly early days in this sort of match yet.
Service judge, Seamus Holman from Ireland.
What I'm a little bit surprised about here is that she's not really trying to bring her into the net with steep slices or moving her full distances. It's a lot more sort of hitting that it's
into the court.
Into the court.
Yeah.
Nearly every single time she's gone up in that deep forehand, she's put a straight smash down with great success.
Yeah.
And you think Linda would already be picking up on that.
I think in watching some of the matches, Linda seems to be playing into the slow side. Would that, if I got that the correct way around, or what did you find in the previous
matches? It's not. That's the Linda's hitting now into the fast end.
Fast
so
side. Okay.
Yeah, and so it's much easier for the Russian to hit and be a bit safer at the back, whereas Linda, when she's hitting there, it's very easy to hit out. And you saw that shuttle is probably because of Linda's accuracy, but that is the way the drift is going.
Yeah.
And there's a marked difference. It really is. To push away from the net. I was coaching a player yesterday and I said, only push to the doubles line because you've got to be safe, because any deeper and it was flying out.
Yeah. You always expect with players of this level that they will be able to deal with the drift, but every hole is very, very different.
And as you well know, Craig, that drift is difficult to deal with. You know, some players can handle it and some players just hate playing with it. Something you've got to learn to do.
Chasing a lot of shuttles but not getting a huge amount of success. But again, some of the rallies quite short as well.
She's slicing, but she's slicing so far back into court that it's not really making the girl move. And the girl's very tall, got great reach.
I think you're right, Ray. The girl's also struggling on that backhand side with the deeper ones. So
yeah.
If she was able to bring them much closer to the forecourt, it would make a difference.
And she's not making those choices at the moment. So that's bringing her in. And there she smashed every single time from that. So you should be able to see the pattern and be able to wait for the smash, cross her, and then she's got to move a full distance. Then I think she'd have problems.
She's just achieved what you've been talking about against the opponent. She's the one that's bringing in the slice to the forecourt, much steeper.
It's got that extra height that helps her. But to me, Linda has not exposed this girl's mobility at the moment. I'm a little bit surprised actually, because Linda's got a lot of deception in the game. She's got shots. She could actually throw in deceptive shots, and she's not really done it yet.
Yeah. Cross court.
There's a bit of that deception that I was talking about, and absolutely left the Russian girl flat-footed. Every time Linda's putting up deep into the Russian girl's deep forehand, she's hitting a power shot, and that really invites the cross, whether you made it short or deep, and then the girl's got to turn, yeah. And I think it would put her into problems. Bang. And yeah. That's exactly what I was saying there, that if you wait for the bang, then cross it, then... could be problems.
I was going to say that Linda being left-handed, it's ideal for her.
Absolutely.
It's probably one of the first times that she's actually looked for it.
That's short. Perhaps you get the right advice now, but one thing that Polikarpova has done really well is her judgment on the court. She's left some tight shuttles, and she's always been right so far.
You can see by the replays, Ray, you talked earlier about the ability to bring your opponent much closer to the net, and it's been the Russians so far that's been providing that service. Again, we talking last night to Mark just about some of the players. You see them with coaches, possibly sometimes with fellow players, friends, but it's a change in time due to finance that quite often players are travelling on their own.
I was actually just saying that earlier, that often you see the Eastern Bloc countries, they're on their own, and they have to learn to fend for themselves, and it makes them quite tough out there on the court. Yeah. You see, I really feel that Linda there, she put the slice in, that put the girl under pressure, then she puts a shot that's on the opposite court, and that is the sort of style of play that she's got to do if she wants to make a break in this game. Like that.
I've got to say that the Russian girl seems to be struggling. The other three corners, I think, are okay.
And now we're back in action.
Five,
definitely moving Polikarpova around the court more. And all credit to the Russian girl, because she is still in the lead, 13-11.
Interesting, sometimes some of the players are often off balance but do decide to go cross court like Linda did there. You know, probably something straight would allow her to get back in the rally.
I agree with you, Craig. They're not really conscious of the percentage play. They're sort of always looking for what's going to give them the edge in the point. And it's been Linda that's made the mistakes in this match so far. She's made the errors that have given that 4-point lead. That's the sort of full distance I'm talking about. If they could move Polikarpova the full distance, it really exposes her mobility.
Another error there from ZETCHIRI.
Poor error.
I think one or two points like that can come back to find you as it gets to 19-all, 20-all. At the moment, the Russians are ahead, so we don't know if it'll reach that.
I think Linda's got away with a few there, because that smash has been working for the Russian girl, and then it just hit the tape there. Full distance.
That's what you spoke about earlier, trying to bring it in and then closer, and then making her turn.
Making her turn, that's exactly it. But right till now, it's not been done well. There's been little patches where Linda's sort of moved her all over the court. And all credit to Polikarpova, she's had really tidy net. She's sort of taken it early, but it's I know Linda as a player, and she's got a lot of deception there, and she's not been using it. Not been using her shots to bring her in, and a number of shots that we could have counted before the front line are negligible. And that's the sort of shot, it was a really simple, slightly slower drop, and it just brought the girl in. And I know Linda's got all these shots.
I think sometimes with the players at this level, Ray, if you're playing well, everything seems to run smoothly. Sometimes it's difficult just to get in a rhythm, but if you're a strong player as Linda is, then if she can get started, as you say, then she's got a lot to offer.
There's the full distance I was talking about, and there she should have been hitting the winner. But the Russian girl could have been kicking herself there, because she actually hit one on her forehand side that was out. Nothing in this now, and we're right at the business end of it. Anybody's game.
Rallies have been quite short the last four or five. I think at this point, as you say, it is business end. So 19-17, you're looking to make sure you're the player that's hitting the court, making your opponent play another shot. Game point to the Russian.
And I really found myself wondering at 17 all, will it be winners or will it be mistakes that lose this match? And invariably it's mistakes. And there's been a sort of mixture there, so that's what she should be doing too. That's turning her. Exactly that. All credit to the Russian girl.
Yeah. Probably the longest rally of the match so far.
Yeah. Very hard fought. Well, a real first close game there, and it's really important that Linda gets in at the start of this second set. That slower drop and slower drop again. Little reverse over there, that's what I would have done.
That's right. I think you've mentioned in the first set that, Linda should be looking to play the corners, turn the girl. I think you got it right. I'm just wondering if she'll be able to execute it in the second set after losing that first set.
Well, I think she played exactly the right type of rally there, but it's hard to do, and I would say this, the Russian girl coped well with the tactics that I'd be using against her. You know, she got lots back there, but it's mounting the pressure. What you mustn't do is give them any unforced errors to give them hope. Got to make her fight for every single point.
That was one of the first times, Ray, that I felt that when there's an opportunity going forward after putting the opponent under pressure at the rear court and actually taking advantage. That's the first time she stepped up to do that.
There's one thing for sure with her, Craig. She's able to put a shuttle away, and that's always puts pressure on your opponent. But rather like Linda did in that long rally, she moved to full distances, and we've just not seen that a lot. Yeah, to me, and I don't know why Linda's not doing this, so she was going to put it back to the same corner, which is a good tactic, but I would have moved her a full distance and got her to that backhand net where she just seems to have that sort of mobility problem that you're looking to expose.
What would you say, Ray, we're playing the Grand Prix level here. What would you say the difference in ladies' singles is between this and sort of Super Series?
Top class women's play now. They've got such a variety of shots. You wouldn't see the number of errors that we're seeing here, and the length of the rallies would be much longer. Everything really is an edge. They just don't give you anything, whereas the girls here are giving. I mean, Linda's played a superb shot there, and I think the umpires overruled the linesman there. Think. Or perhaps not. It was a very tight shot, and I believe it was just out. Linda hit a superb shot, but just out.
Again, you can see the difficulties that the Russian girl is struggling on that left side. She gets the shuttle back, but I do think she's slightly weaker on the left side. She's got to turn, go down.
Ah, oh, it's a good shot from the Russian there. Keep saying what Linda should be doing to win the match, but if I was Polikarpova's coach, I'll be getting her to hit a little bit more, because Linda's not really had the answer when she's brought out raw power.
Yeah. Yeah, she got success with that at the start of the first half of the earlier game. She was getting success, especially on Linda's forehand side. I think some more of that would make a difference.
Oh, that's a great shot. And you was asking earlier, Craig, what is the big difference between this standard and Super Series standard? The real main answer that I would give to that is pace.
Yeah.
That the girls are just that pace quicker, and that creates more gaps, and they make less mistakes.
Opportunity missed there.
Careless error, careless. And an expensive error as well. Difference between 7-5 and 6-all.
Polikarpova sort of pulling away again, Ray. Same, it was quite close at the start of the first set, and then she pulled away 3 or 4 points. It's happening again.
And she's pulling away because of Linda's mistakes. Not really, because she's doing too much about it. If Linda could stop making the mistakes, she'd stand a good chance here. That's a good shot.
Just looking ahead, Ray, I think if both these players are fairly young, so an opportunity to play in the BWF World Championships, which are coming to Glasgow, again in this arena. So the chance to play and get that experience at this point in their careers. Looking forward to 2017 could be a valuable one.
I agree. Made a few mistakes there when she's been cut down, which is exactly what you the point
yeah,
you were making earlier.
Left side.
Yeah. But what Linda seems to be doing, she seems to be plugging that deep forehand a lot of the time, which I prefer really that she was moving the girl more.
Yeah. The girl is quite strong in deep forehand as well, so
yep.
I think to exploit that area on the left forecourt, she's going to have to use the other three corners and then be patient, eventually go for the winner from there.
Sometimes in coaching, I think you can give too much information. I think you've got to get very clear messages through just in short points that just like you're saying there, that try and turn her and get her moving down into a backhand net side. But if you elaborate too much, I think you can confuse players.
Yeah, yeah. I think it's also knowing the person you're working with.
I agree.
And making sure that you're quite clear and concise. And some players can take 3, 4, 5 things, others one or two. Again, it's just having that knowledge.
So I agree with what Linda tried to do there, that she's moving her and then cross-netting, giving no time. She's got that great shot from that forehand side. So hit it with good angle there, and normally she's hitting it with power. It's a good variation. Oh, nice, great shot.
Yeah, nice drop.
And you can definitely tell what Linda was told in the 90 seconds there. It was to cross net.
I think on that race, especially from Linda's forehand to the opponent's backhand side, that again, that's the area we've been talking about that she struggles, I think.
Oh. And the Russian girl won that rally twice because she hit one that was definitely out.
I think we're looking at some of the areas at POLIKARPOVA is struggling in, but overall physically she's pretty strong.
And what when you've got a knee strapped up like that, and you'll know this, Craig, you're playing with pain, and so she's pretty tough as well.
Yeah. I think if Linda ZETCHIRI loses this match, I think looking at her video afterwards, she'll identify with the unforced errors. And to be fair, losing maybe 21-17, it was at least 3, 4, 5 unforced errors, so she needs to pick it up a bit.
She's not been listening to you enough, Craig, because she's needs to get it into that backhand front of the court and move her opponent and turn her opponent. There's a winning shot there and she plays it out, and it's really been the story of this match. And 4 points, second set. It's a nice little buffer.
Yeah.
A lot of players would be happy with that.
Yeah, I think at this point, Ray, the Russian girl is just be consistent and continue to do what she's been doing. Keep that lead.
Because really, in a way, And that showed it is Linda's losing the match. Yeah. Beating herself a bit.
I think the Russian player trying to influence the line judge. It was pretty close, but she was calling before it landed.
And Linda showing a trait that she's got. She can be quite aggressive on the court, and her emotions come to the ball quite easily.
Watching Linda the last time, I think I've watched the full match, was probably when she played Kirsty Gilmer, probably around about 2012, 2013 in a tournament in London. But I'm sort of looking at her, wondering if her world ranking has sort of stayed the same or has she improved. It's difficult to tell.
My guess is that her world ranking at the moment might be a little bit lower than she's had before. I know we haven't got the computer to check it, but I know she'll be chasing sort of Olympic points. But Linda's gone through periods where she's had really good results. She's actually not that young, because she's I can remember playing against our juniors quite some time. She's about 29.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know the age of
she
the Russian girl.
She has been around for a while, but
yeah, she has. Yeah,
got a few years in her yet. I think many of these players have got a nice life in a way, but it's quite a tough life. A lot of travelling on the road, and as you can see today, the Russian's got no coach. I don't know if she's got any teammates with her, so. Quite often on your own, but the rewards are worth it.
Oh, Linda should have been on top of that.
Again, 17-18 in the second. You were wondering, Ray, last time at 17-all how it would go. Would it be quality of strokes and
mistakes,
good rallies, or was it mistakes to end the match?
Yeah. And last time it was a bit of a mixture.
Yes! Yes!
It's interesting you mentioned Linda, and sometimes gets quite aggressive, but she's starting to show a bit more emotion. Possibly if that was there earlier on.
There's definitely been a little bit of influence on the tight line calls, wouldn't you say?
Yeah.
Even if it's been right, but I mean, there's been vocal when there's been tight line calls. And this is typical when it gets to the business end of a match, it becomes a lot more attacking.
Yeah.
So to me, that's winning a point, what she's just done.
Yeah, she'd maybe been just sitting back a bit more in earlier points.
Yeah. She's better when she's a bit more aggressive.
Hey.
One thing's for sure, Craig, that we both know at 19 all, they're both going to be going for every single opportunity. So you can expect more attacking play. Neither of them are confident enough to extend the rallies and play the rallies at this stage. They're both going to be going for it. And actually, it's probably going to be a fair result because Linda's made far too many unforced errors, really.
Yeah, I would agree, Ray. There's not a lot in it. They've both made errors, both played some really good rallies at times, but two or three mistakes, as I mentioned earlier on, can be the difference.
And I really feel that the Polikarpova has made the most of herself here, whereas I don't think Linda has. I think there's been opportunities for Linda to go ahead. Very, very nervous point this is going to be, I think.
Okay, 2019?
2019. Tail down, giving them lots of time to think about it. And a net called to make it 20 all.
I think the experience of Linda just being in a tight position, she's able to still carry out the quality on the net.
If I speak the truth, that could either be a brilliant shot or a mistake. Yeah. You know, it's she could have just been walking off of this court, but it's that's what you get with Linda. It's either really good shots or...
Yeah, she's almost turned it around.
Almost.
From match point down to game point down to game point up.
It's one of those now where anything can happen. But it's definitely got more aggressive in this last sort of 4 or 5 points that we've seen, as I expected. And it will stay like that. And if we take it back just a couple of points, you said to me, do you think she's got better? That could have either been brilliant or a mistake.
Yeah.
And it was a mistake. There's just nothing in it. Oh, that's a great shot. And to me, Craig, that's the sort of shot she should have been playing a lot more often. And... instead, she's often been hitting at the girl's body, where she's been quite good. There's really nothing in this match. Anything could happen.
Hey. Yes! Yes! Game point saved, match point saved. And second set to Linda Zetchiri. I don't think at this point, Ray, I'm looking to see a huge amount of change in the tactical battle between them. I think they're both striving just to try and play slightly better quality and try and play their own games.
I think if anything happens, that Linda could settle a little bit more and get her shots working a bit better and perhaps learn from that fine cut that she just played in there.
But again, you can see by the replay, just an error to lose the set. And I think at this level, you've always got to be playing the court, making sure that you're involved in the rallies to give yourself a real chance. Thank you.
And don't forget, we have a hashtag SOGP if you want to tweet us on what you're thinking of the Scottish Open. And there's some fabulous badminton being played here in the five events. And it literally does just cost a few pounds to get in, and people have got the opportunity to watch top-class badminton. And it'll be the best badminton you see in Scotland this year, so please, please come along. Tomorrow they'll be playing to the quarter-final stage, and Saturday it'll be the semi-finals, and Sunday the finals. And it's just a magnificent arena. Craig has had to go off to cover a match and prepare his players for a ladies' doubles match. And I'm left on my lonesome. And as so often happens, Linda scraped and literally did just scrape through that second set, and now settling a little bit more and getting a much more clarity in what she's got to try and do with this very good Russian player, because I really think that the Russian girl Polikarpova is hindered with her right knee, and if she was a fraction mobile, she's got great power, good net play to feed that strength. I think she would be a handful for Linda to play against. Not that she isn't now. See, if I think Linda had got that over, I think it might well have been a winner, and that's she's letting herself down so badly by these careless errors right at the end of rallies. The number of times you'll see it in the next few rallies, Linda gets to that backhand net side, and she then plays it over to Polikarpova's deep forehand, and she's got to vary that. If she was to just hold the net another shot, or play it cross, then it would affect the pattern, and she'd get a better end result. And although there's nothing in this match, I feel the Bulgarian girl is just settling a little bit better in this third set. And with a 3-point buffer, all of a sudden Linda could afford to be a little bit more confident, play a few more shots, and that's when she's good. little bit of deception there down the Polikarpova's forehand side. And that's where it's really exposing her mobility. Two careless errors there from Linda. And the Russian girl really fighting for every single point here. And Linda helping her a little bit with the careless errors. Oh, that's a good shot. Linda's won that point, and really it should have been the Russian's point, because the shot that Linda hit on the sideline was definitely going out, and the Russian attacked it, and Linda just reacted and was able to get the shuttle back. I always say it to the players that I coach, sidelines are so expensive, and Linda's proving this time and time again. No need for that shot to be so tight. Very little in this match, really. Linda just having the edge, but they're going to change ends, and it could suit the Russian because she's quite an attacking player, likes her power, and that's a fast end. She's now hitting on the fast side. But it does mean that Linda can hit with a bit more ease towards the back of the court, and so she's more comfortable in the rallies. Don't forget, we have a hashtag, SOGP, if you want to give us your thoughts. Excellent rally for Zetchiri there, pushing Polikarpova all around the court. And the greatest danger that Zetchiri's got is beating herself. And there's that lovely deception she's got, and it's just when she's got like a 4-point lead, then she's just freer to play her shots. What a careless, careless error. And that's a feature of Zetchiri's play, is that she's just served one out and then she plays absolutely brilliantly on the net, and she's got such good shots, but she's just prone to careless errors. Excellent, excellent rally from Linda Zetchiri there, moving Polikarpova all over the court, playing a few slow drops, which she hasn't done too much in this match, and then that really makes the Russian girl move full distances, and it's going to give Zetchiri the edge if she can do that without making the errors. Points in it, which is quite a lot at this stage in the match, but it's going to be really important that Linda doesn't make too many errors. Really good tactic there. She played a slice down the line that was quite deep, so it's turning her opponent, and then she put a cross-court smash to her forehand side, so completing the turn of the player. And that's an area that I think the Russian girl should have exploited a lot earlier in this match. I feel that Linda Sakiri has been quite weak down that deep forehand side. Quite a lot of debate about badminton players becoming more vocal because the world champion from Spain, Carolina Marin, is very vocal and very motivated on the court, rather like you're seeing with Sakiri all the time at the moment, and some people just don't like it. Me, I'm all for it. Super play by POLIKARPOVA there. A 6-point deficit. A lot to make up at this stage of the game. There's that cut that Craig was talking about earlier to really put pressure on the Russian. And I think he was 100% right. And it's easier to get your tactics right, it's easier to get your game right at 19-12 than when it's been really tight and there's a lot of pressure on you. Definitely in this match, you've seen, although I think the players have been right each time, a bit of influence of the line judging. And perhaps the line judges haven't been influenced, but the players have tried. And that's up to the officials in the game to keep that under control and be told to the players to stop it. And as I said earlier, the biggest danger to Sakiri is Sakiri. She makes far too many errors. Just missing the lines, and that's, I can count, that's probably happened 8 times in this one match. And this is where Sakiri has to steady the ship, make sure she doesn't give any more unforced errors away. So that's a weak area. So if you see what she's missing by there, it's, well, I'm going to say inches, and I'm very old. What a way to lose a match. The ebbs and flows of that match, and it's lost by a half-court serve that goes into the tram lines and nearly out of the doubles lines. And although that's a poor ending, it just goes to show the pressures and the nerves that are in these matches. We're going to take a short break and we'll be back with you shortly.